Hey, it's Tim.
And it's Amy from Go With Less. We're really glad that you're here with us today. In today's video, we're going to get deep into our channel name, Go With Less. We get a lot of Go With Less as like a challenge to us whenever we're doing anything that isn't quote unquote going with less. So we want to get deep into that today, and I hope that you'll stay tuned.
Every Wednesday here on our channel, we put out a new video talking about our nomadic life or our early retirement. In 2015, we retired in our late 40s and left our careers. And in 2020, in January of 2020, we sold our home and we became full-time nomads. And so, just like Amy said, we were excited to talk about why we are going with less.
And in order to understand why it matters so much to us, I think it's important to give you some sort of idea of what our life was like before we retired in 2015. So let's backtrack 5-6 years a little bit here and share what that was like. We lived in a 6,000 square foot McMansion in a suburb of Denver, Colorado with our three children. We worked really, really hard. We had maybe 2 weeks or so of vacation a year, and work was our life.
So I traveled 3 to 5 days a week. I was on a plane a lot. So when I got home on the weekends, I was there to be there with the children as well as take care of our yard and our giant house. So I was either in the yard mowing or I was shoveling. The funny thing is, we had this patio on the back porch. So most all this time I spent taking care of the yard, we were never in the yard. So the person or what who spent the most time in our yard was our dog. And so I guess I was doing all this work for the dog, but we spent a lot of time just maintaining our house. It seemed like a lot of our life was about either taking care of the yard or taking care of the house, which I wasn't even in for half the week often.
Or working to pay for the house.
Yeah, that's right.
So we realized around 2014 that if we let go of our home, that opened up a lot of opportunities for us. Back then, we were spending $115,000 a year on our life. And again, we had three children and a dog and a big house. And even though we didn't have other debt aside from our mortgage, that just is our spending. So that doesn't account for any kind of savings or taxes or things like those sorts of things. Money that we actually spent was about $115,000. So that is, like I said, who we were. And what we realize is like this 2 weeks of vacation and this whole idea of keeping our giant house as our kids were getting older and moving out, we really didn't need that anymore. And our house was holding us back.
In 2014, before we actually put our home on the market, that's when we kind of came to the realization that if we got rid of this huge house, and I'm going to call it an albatross, then we could actually move down this path of retirement much more quickly. And so that's when this realization came. Also, something to note is that we didn't have any plans to be nomads in 2014 or 2015, I think even later. So this is something that we came to the realization this is something we wanted to do further on. So when it comes to going with less, it had nothing to do when we came up with the name about being nomads. It was primarily about less spending and how much we felt like that could contribute to our life.
And it wasn't just less spending, because cutting out our house took about $6,500 a month. All of our spending came down $6,500 a month. The vast majority of it was our house and all that came with it. We did have a housekeeper because we both worked a lot and it was a big house. So the cost of having someone else clean it, the utilities, the upkeep of replacing broken things, and just the property taxes and insurance and all of that that goes with the house. So it wasn't just the spending, it was also the physical size of our house. So as our kids started moving out, as our poor dog passed away, we didn't need so much of a house anymore. And we really embraced the idea that we could live in a smaller space. So we moved to our rental townhouse with our youngest daughter, who was the only one left in school at that time. And so it was just the three of us in our rental townhouse, and we went down to 1,800 square feet.
Yep, so moving to the smaller space also implied, and so you may connect the dots here on your own, but that we got rid of a lot of our stuff. So we went through this exercise of getting rid of things. We sold a car. So we got rid of a lot of things in our life. So we were going through this exercise of having less stuff. And again, that sort of, we resonated again with this going with less, because we were getting rid of stuff, spending less money. So there's just lots of less in our life as we were going through this exercise.
And something that was huge for both of us, it really stuck better with Tim, was losing weight. So when Tim went from being a road warrior on the road 3 to 5 days a week, he we were cooking healthier food at home. And Tim kind of effortlessly lost 35-ish pounds that he's maintained because he wasn't having those expense account sorts of salesy meals, sales kind of meeting meals. I don't know, 3 days a week, three times a week, three meals a day. Yeah. So you were able just to take off 35 pounds, boom.
I called that the whatever Amy puts in front of me diet. So that worked for me. And she was putting better things, obviously, than what I was picking for myself when I was out on the road.
So yeah. That worked. Tim said I weighed less than I weighed in high school. I never thought I could get down to this weight. I said, aren't you so proud of yourself? Like, that's such a huge accomplishment. He said it actually felt kind of effortless. So I feel like I've had this accomplishment, but I didn't put the work into it. So
didn't earn it.
Yeah, I didn't even earn it. I'm like, whatever. So meanwhile, I struggle constantly, and that's another video. But okay, also, when Tim talks about our things, so it wasn't just like a progression of the going down to the 1800 square feet, but then we continued to go down again. So now we are in a storage unit. We're in a 10 by 5 storage unit, 50 square feet plus our current car of stuff. And that's where everything we have is housed.
There are a lot of ways in our life where we feel like we are going with more. So this more is just something that for whatever reason, we've actually had folks before say, you should change your channel name to Go With More because it seems like you have this life that's full. And so somehow less is something that doesn't resonate as well with people. Well, less resonates a lot with us. So something else that I think is equally important in our name is that first word, that go. So when we started our channel, and we still obviously love to travel, being full-time nomads, but in 2015, we had just intentions of traveling frequently. And so the thing that allowed us to do that is we have a lot of credit cards. We do travel hacking using those credit cards to earn points and miles, and those points and miles allow us to effectively travel for free. And so again, we got to travel for less. So that go was an important part of our name.
However, in order to travel as often as we do, Tim is incredibly involved with travel hacking. So this is going to get to, just because we're go with less doesn't mean our goal is to be going with nothing. We were with friends yesterday, nomadic friends, and they offered something that said, like, you can have things. Like, you don't have to have nothing. You can have things. And certainly we understand that, but our audience will sometimes challenge us when maybe our spending is a little bit higher than we had anticipated, or we're buying something that isn't an absolute necessity. So our intention is not to go to nothing. Or even someone on our video a couple weeks ago, when we said that we're trying to aim to stay in a place for maybe 6 weeks to have that settled kind of feeling, said you're more like you're staying with less. And I don't know that I disagree quite a bit, actually. Just because we are buying something that enhances our life, all we're trying to do is to find an optimal way of life for us. Is it way less compared to our former working career lives? In pretty much every way, we have decreased all kinds of factors that allow us to live this life of freedom. So we have more freedom. We don't have less of everything. We have more free time. We have more freedom. We have more time with friends. Like, we have more travel. We have more of things that are very important to us, but we got rid of like the stuff that was bogging us down. So I really just want to chat a little bit about what it is that we're not looking to be small in everything. We just talked about the RVs.
Yeah, so I think not only RVs, but before we go into that, so 30 credit cards is something that most people would say there is no way that is going with less. The fact that you own 30 credit cards and you have to manage that and deal with that. And so I call that like it's a part-time hobby. It's a hobby for me. Amy says sometimes it turns into a part-time job when it comes to managing these credit cards. So there's plenty of places in our life where we are not necessarily going with less. And so less usually just ties into our spending. But last week or a few weeks ago, we had a video talking about the reasons we wouldn't want to be in an RV. And one of the reasons that we mentioned is it just seems space constrained. So we want a little more space. So we found sort of a happy place with our space in terms of how much space we feel like we need. And that's what works for us. So tiny homes and RVs and van life, these things are things that we watch with curiosity, but I think they're just not enough space for us. And so again, we're not going with less when it comes to space. We want a perfect amount of space.
And for us, actually, the perfect amount of space we're finding is maybe a one bedroom, kind of an apartment, maybe a two bedroom at the most, but compared to our old life, the fact that we're looking at a one bedroom apartment is like our ideal space is a little extreme for where we have come from. So I think it's really important to see our progression. And again, just because we're going with less doesn't mean that we're not looking to be going with nothing been going with zero, getting down to minimalism. I'm going to try to find a video from The Minimalist that I found so funny. I'm going to put it down in the description below. It's a YouTube video. I am going to warn you, there's a little bit of the F word is in it. So if your kids are around in that video, just be aware of that. But it is so funny. And the idea is that we're just putting things of value, like maximizing the value in our life.
Something Amy mentioned earlier is that we're often challenged on our channel with, are we going with less? Are we doing the right things? And we feel like we are. So some places where we like the accountability that comes with talking about our numbers in a public way. So this $36,000 a year that we're looking to spend, $3,000 a month, we talk about that every month here on our channel. And sometimes we go under, sometimes we're over. So it depends on the month. But nonetheless, we like, I think, being challenged. We like having that accountability. I think that's part of the reason we have the channel. So it's not like we're upset that people are challenging us about going with less. It's just something that it's just an interesting dynamic.
Where do you go with less really well? Where in your life can you add in a little more to maximize your life? And maybe it is more freedom or more spare time or time with your children or something, more time to exercise, whatever. So maybe you're really, really cheap with yourself and you might want to spend a little more money. Maybe you're too cheap. So where can you go with less? Can you go with more? Where are you doing rock solid? And we'd love to hear down below in the comments. And with that, we are going to see you next Wednesday.
Adios.